So now I'm going to talk about the scales of measurements. Without knowing the basics of scales of measurement, no one can go for the real research. Particularly now you are moving to the research world, because in the fourth semester and third semester, you must focus on the how to do your research only. For this, I'm going to define what is measurement, scales of measurement. The scales of measurement refers to way in which variable or numbers are defined and categorized. Even if you go for any kind of data or variables, we must know what kind of scales it may lies there. Suppose if I'm taking as emotional intelligence as one of my variable for doing the research, for as a researcher, I must know whether the emotional intelligence may come at the nominal scale or ordinal scale or interval or ratio scale. So without knowing, we could not be go for any kind of research. Even why this kind of scales of measurement is needed in this sense, based on the scales only, we have to be find what statistical techniques we can adopt for finding the appropriate statistics based on the types of scales only. So if the scales is in a nominal data, we have to select the other statistics like frequency distribution and all. So if the scales is to be lie on the format of interval or ratio, we can go for some kind of parametric statistics. So in this manner, it seems that the scales of measurement is very important things in the particularly in the aspects of research. These things we already know that according to the Stevens 1946, some other textbook he had given the other years also, he classified the measurement, the scales into four scales. One is called nominal scale, ordinal scale, interval scale, as well as the ratio scales. We will go one by one for discussions. Normally the nominal scale and ordinal scale is also called as a qualitative measure or in a categorical variable or in a categorical variable. Normally we can classify the four classification of the types of variable or measurement scales into two. One is called quantitative, other one is called qualitative. The first two things is lies on the qualitative scales. The last two, interval and ratios, means lies on the quantitative. This only I'm going to highlight now. The nominal and ordinal scales is also called as qualitative measures. Normally, we can classify into non-numerical categories. We could not be come for any kind of number, magnitude-based measurement won't be available. We had to be only the characteristics-based. Suppose I want to divide the people into two groups, I may take in consideration of gender as a categorization, like male and female. But dividing the people in male and female, so I'm using the strategies like categorical way I'm going to categorize the people. Therefore, it's called as nominal data. So here I am not taking as consideration for any kind of numerical data to divide the peoples. The ordinal represents order. The term itself, you can easily understand the order. If you are, for example, what is your preference? Which food you are taking? Which is your first preference for taking the food? I'm asking the question, idli, dosa or sambar. You are giving the first preference. There is a ranking is there. And also, suppose if you're asking the what is your birth order in your home, you may second place, you may birth in your home, or first place, third place. You are giving me one order, that is a order of your place, but it may be a number, but the number is showing the position of yours, not for the any kind of quantitative measurements there. This kind of variable scale is called as a qualitative measures. We are not using any kind of numerical value here. The next variable, the two variables is called interval, so next two scales is called interval or ratio. It may lies in the category of quantitative measures. Here the value is much very much important. Even in the case of personality, or if you are measuring the height and weight, we are checking the some measurements. So it may be 55 kilogram to 70 gram. Like that, there is a number value is there. We are measuring anything through the quantity based. Damn sure that kind of variable or data may lies on the interval ratio. I am going to deeply about the difference between the nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio one by one. These are basic assumptions. Actually, even the Stevens also, he divide the measurement scale based on the three characteristics. The category one is called magnitude. Second category is called equal. Third category is absolute. There is nothing but characteristics other properties. For dividing the scales into four nominal, ordinal, integral, and ratio, as a statistician, we are using this kind of three characteristics or properties. Magnitude, what is the magnitude? Magnitude means the numerical value. So if you are using any kind of numerical value, if you are using any kind of numerical value to measure something, then only it's called magnitude. In the sense, it's a numerical value. So number represents some measurement, isn't it? That is called magnitude. So next one is called equal interval. What is the equal intervals? Here the equal intervals refers, that's particularly we have the scores. For example, I'm conducting an examination to you. Some of the students may get the score 65, some of the students may get the score 75. Like that, there is a up to 100, you maybe get the scores from the 0 to 100 or 1 to 100. Sometimes I'm going to classify the people's mark into group wise, 1 to 10, 1 to 10, then 11 to 20, then 21 to 30. This kind of categorization is called equal interval. If you are able to divide the scores or the magnitude value into equal way, then it's called equal intervals. The third category is called absolute zero. Some of the characteristics of variable may lie on zero. Particularly if you are taking the consideration of the height, weight. Best example is some kind of physical measurements. Suppose now if I go to your classroom, if I take the attendance in the real classroom, so next to only the classroom is there, if I go and check it, no students are there. It means that today is the present in a real mode is zero, but in online mode nearly 19 people are there. So here I am going to measure that a particular value may reach up to zero. That kind of variable is called as an absolute zero properties, that's right. So based on this only the four categories coming, nominal, ordinal, and interval. The nominal scale not satisfying the anything, magnitude equal and absolute zero, that's why I put into mark. So into mark represents nothing is present, tick mark represents presence the characteristics. The nominal scale is like a purely based on the property. For example, if I ask you a name, you are giving one name. That number is labeling for you. That name is labeling for you. Therefore, it's called nominal data. So here you are not giving any kind of numbers and all. But even if I ask you your enrollment number, you are giving the number, but the number labeling or denotes your things only. So that number act for you only. So here the number sometimes may be number, but the number referring or denoting you only. It means that it's like a label, that is a number is labeling for you or tag for you. Therefore, it's not having the magnitude value, it's only the characteristics value or the properties of value. So that kind of variable is called as a nominal data. Even if I'm asking your door number, you are telling the door number 5, door number 6. The door number represents your home only. Right? Here it may be number, but the number, it's a labeling or the tag to reach your homes. Suppose how the people are writing the letter with your home address only. So they write the door number with the entire address, then only it may comes to you as a letter. So I hope you may understand what is my nominal in the sense. It may be number, but the number won't be consideration for this magnet value. It may be denote as a characteristics or the labeling of one person. Therefore, the nominal not satisfying the magnitude value, equal values, equal interval, as well as absolute zero. But in the case of ordinal, it's only the order base. I already mentioned the order base. But the order having some number, for example, if I'm asking you what is the position of birth in your home, you are telling us here first place, second place, third place. So your birth order shows one location or one position. Here the number may be there, but the position shows the number represents your position of birth only. So here we are not dividing the birth order into category like 0 to 5 birth. 5 to 6 to 10 birth, we could not be categorized like equal intervals. Therefore, the second property, it may satisfy it only the magnitude, not in the equal and the absolute zero. If you see the, none of the people's not birth order is zero order. There is no order for zero order. It may be first order or second order. You may be born as a first child, second child, third child, last child. That is an order. But no one comes as a zero order. Therefore, the ordinal data not satisfying the absolute zero also. The third variable or third scales we are going to talk about the interval. The interval satisfying the magnitude as well as the equal intervals, but not in the absolute zero. So the best example, personality. or the intelligence, even the textbook of the psychology book, whenever you're seeing the intelligence chapters, they classify like 70 to 90 90 to 110 110 to 130, like that they categorize the intelligence of people. But if you look in the lowest level, they won't start with zero, because that personality or the this kind of intelligence won't reach the zero. It won't reach the zero sphere. So because even the mental retarder or the birth child, they know little of intelligence. Therefore, the none of the personality variable or the psychological variable won't reach the zeros level. But we can easily classify the scores in equal intervals, like I already mentioned 70 to 90, 90 to 110. So it means that there is a gap, is that 70 to 90, 20 numbers, interval is 20. Then similarly, 90 to 110, 20 numbers, that kind of interval we are able to divide it, but that particular variable won't reach the zero scores. The last variable, last states, we are going to talk about the ratio. The ratio, it is nothing but here these two things present, three things present: magnitude, equal, as well as the absolute zero. All the three things present in this context of the ratio. Normally we are talking as a physical variable. Physical variable. So if you are measuring anything in physical representation based, then that variable won't sometimes may reach the zero. For example, I want to check the weight of gold. Sometimes we go for a mall in the jewelers shops, they may weighing the things through the some closed weighing machines. Even it shows the 0.005 gram, 0.0008 gram, somewhat it may reach zero. So there is a position, it may start with a zero. Some of the, for example, I don't have gold. So suppose some people are come and measuring that, how many golds I am having. Nothing I am in the sense, zero comes. So if I am going to Anita home, I am checking, I may found 100. If I going to the Cyril home, I get 150 gold gram. So here, each homes have some gold, but in my home is nothing. So there is a chance, if you're checking the same weighing machines with how many pounds we have in the different homes, sometimes some of the homes it may be zero, some of the homes it may 100, 200, some, there's a chance it may come. Therefore, we are able to magnitude, we are able to divide in equal manner, like how many people having the 100 less than 10 grams, then 10, 11 to 20 grams and 21 to 30 grams, we are able to categorize. Then sometimes the particular variable, it may come to zero also. Yeah, so the Cyril is telling that in my home is zero. Yeah, so this is, it's hypothetically is wrong. So we know that we don't have nothing, that's why we are not considering anything. You have something, that's why you're considering wrong. So yeah, damn sure you are writing one thing is no, entail is to be wrong. Be cautious before typing here. Yeah, so the scale. Based on the above category, we are going to categorize like this also. The scale, we know the four scales. The indication difference indicates directions of difference, indicate amount of difference, and absolute zero. So the previous things I'm going to give it into four ways. And the nominal scale, the first one is present, but in the previous things, nothing is present, but here they indicate, put as an indications of difference. Yeah, so the Surya's typing is an all-in bank. Yeah, the bank, the term bank represents a nominal data. Yeah, because the bank means Canara Bank, SBA Bank. So here, so we are going to divide the bank based on the names. Therefore, it's called as a nominal data. That's why indication difference. They say differences happen. What is the difference happen? Canara Bank, SBA Bank, then like all the other banks, all the nationalist bank and all, we are categorize the banks into different names. That names is to be asked or labeled for the particular banking only. Therefore, it's called as a nominal. So the nominal, the first one is present, indication of differences. The differences purpose, they are using some kind of names. In the ordinal data, indication differences, indication of directional differences to be permissible. It is enabled. It means that I am telling that who is the, suppose I am going to make it a order based on those who are having much gold in your home. In this case, I found that the Surya's home having a lot of gold. The last one, the Cyril's home, very low. So there is a position. So number one position, Surya. The number one, second position, Anita. Number three position, Prasanna. Then Safayur. Like that, I am giving the position of the people. Then seventh Arya, then eighth Anushri, then ninth Adira, then Bhavana, Drisha, Kirti, Krishna. Like that, the order. The final comes to the Cyril. So here, we can easily find the direction also. So now you know the direction, ascending order and descending order. That is called direction. Suppose I am asking the question, who is the less in your gold in your home? Gold in your home, any person, if you tell in the sense, immediately we are telling the person name of Cyril. So that is called indication of direction of difference. Therefore, the ordinal data, we are able to make a directions, the difference also permissible. In the case of interval, the three things to be permissible. Indication of difference, sure. The indication direction of difference as well as it indicates amount of difference. The previous case, I am telling that who is having much gold in your home, the ranking system you are putting. But if I ask him that how many kilograms Surya's home having, how many kilograms the Prasanna home's having. For example, the Prasanna's home nearly 80 kilograms. In the Surya's home, it's 95 kilograms. Then in the case of Anita, in the case of Sufair having nearly 110 kilograms of gold. So in this case, the highest one Sufair, but even though we are putting the differences from Anita to Prasanna to Surya, having some difference or the, in the scoring, what is the amount of the gold having the homes should be somewhat different is there. So that it seems that it indicates the amount of difference between the each other. Yeah, then final one is called absolute zero. So I already mentioned that that's only permissible in the ratio scale. In the ratio scale, you may find out the that absolute zero is to also enable or should be accepting. It means that some cases, some of the students not having the gold in your homes. So that times only it means zeros. That's why the most of the physical variables means lies on the may lies on the zero. So always don't think that always the physical variable may lies on the ratio. Sometimes it may lies on the interval also. Only the little confusion may happen, the interval and the ratio. We feel that most of them look like the same. Only the condition to differ, only the ratio as well as the interval for lying the absolute zero. Yeah, I think Sivakavya homes having 150 kilograms. So she may be number one, it seems. She may be number one, it seems. Yes, next. The nominal scale, the definition is that the first level of measurement scale in which the numbers serve as tags or labels to classify or identify the objects. A nominal scale usually deals with non-numerical values. This already we mentioned. These non-numerical values are the numbers that don't have any value. Even if you're representing one value, for example, I'm asking what is your home's location's pin code. You are telling one number is a pin code, but the pin code representing your area's location one. So don't think that it's a number. Here the number represents the your area only. Therefore, sometimes it may be numeric value, but it's not numeric value won't be consideration magnitude value. It's only the character value. It adopts as a character. So it's not like a magnitude value. The nominal scale, simple classifications of objects or items into discrete groups. Categorical data and numbers that are simply used as identifiers or names represent a nominal scale or measurements. This is simple definition. So I already mentioned the nominal scale does not satisfy the three properties. Magnitude value is nil. Then it not satisfy the equal intervals. And the third one, it's not satisfying the absolute zero. So this means that it's like a characteristics or property base. You are dividing the people or dividing anything that is called nominal data. That's when the second line I'm highlighting. Categorical data and numbers that are simply used as identifier. Even I am using your enrollment number as identifier. Therefore, it's called as a nominal scale. The best example of nominal scale, like what is your gender? What is your hair color? Where do you lie? So here you are giving the responses. The responses not having any kind of numeric value. Even I put these chrome, the what is your hair color, I'm typing the number 1 brown, 2 black, 3 blend. But then here number not having any value, that 1 represent brown, 2 represent black, 3 represent blonde, then 4 represent beige. So that number represent the character only, a category only. So in this case, don't be thinking that I'm using number, nothing here, the characteristics category only. These are the some of the examples of nominal skills. The first one is called gender. If I divide the gender into male, female, transgender, because it's a category, the matter status like married, unmarried, then state, which, so I'm blank to Tamil Nadu, you are blank to Kerala, like that. If I'm able to divide the people into state wise, then it's called. Then college major, suppose some students are the science major, arts major, or other majors. So it's like a category, we are using some characteristics. Then the zip code, even the postal code, it may be number, but the number is not representing the magnitude value. It's only representing the persons, student ID, then eye color. Before going to the ordinary data, just I'm going to conduct a small activity on it. I request you all to minimize your screen and come back to the meter. There is a code I'm going to share you. There is called Meeting Pulse. Meeting Pulse. I'm going to conduct a small activity. So I'm opening the Meeting Pulse nominal database. I'm going to conduct a small activity on you. I request all go with meet.pulse. Meet, I'm typing the chat box, the link, meet.ps. Everything small letter. So this is meet.ps/nominal. So you can give the term as a nominal. So here I'm going to give the 3 example for nominal. I request all to connect with me, meet.ps. I'm sharing the link, meet.ps. Everything small letter. meet.ps/nominal. There's a 3 questions only. So once you joined, I may activate it. Please, I request you all to connect with me. If you have the laptop, you can use the other tab and go with this. Yeah, 4 students are joined. Those who are joining, there is a question and answer. You can type your name. The question and answer, you may find the Q&A options. There you can type your name. Please, I request you all type your name in the question and answer. Then only I can know who are coming here. You may find the question and answer options. There you can type your names one by one. Yes. Yeah, Arya is present. So very good. Arya is there, it seems. So Arya is presented as the first person. Anita is also came. Anita, she joined as a 3rd person. Arya joined as a 6th person. So here the attendee names are there. The next, so remaining 10 people are joined. Yeah, so now I'm going to activate the, the Drisha is joined as 9th girl. Yeah, that's why she's 9th is there. Yeah, here this is attendee, you know, it's representing number of position when you join. So this is called ordinal data. So in my screen, you are getting attendee 6, attendee 3, attendee 9. It means that you are, Drisha joined as 9th girl in this meeting. Anita joined as a 3rd girl as a meeting. Then Arya is joined as a 6th participant as the meeting. It's a position. But the names show here, the top Arya, Anita and Drisha is represent the characteristics, is represent the, that particular participants only. So it seems that this is, then type, you are typing the name, no? That name is called nominal data. That positions while you join, that is called as an ordinary data. I hope you may have some clarity. Now Musambil also joined, but he's joined as 8th. Now 14 are joined. Thank you so much. Now I'm going to activate the first questions. What is the gender? You are going to give the response. So I hope you may get in your end, in your mobile phone. Yeah. So I got four options. So I got 8 responses, 9 responses. See, in this case, you are giving one responses. I'm asking the question as a gender. This is like a data collection. While going for data collections, you are using some demographic variable for doing data collections. That time you are asking the question, what is the gender? The people are giving the 2 responses, male and female. From this, I can easily understand 27%. Here, the answer only the number is there. But I'm categorizing the people, male and female. That categorization Likewise, if you're dividing, then it's called as a nominal data. So I got 12 responses. Out of 12 responses, 25% are male, 75% are female. It is like a output. It is, so here we are checking the frequency only. After frequency, it's converting as a percentage. Now the second question for you. Now I'm going to activate the second question. Locality of your home. So kindly give your answers. So I'm going to collect your data based on the two questions. What is the locality? Whether you are situated in the rural area or urban area. Now you are giving the answer. I got 7 responses. So it means that 7 people are giving the responses. 7 people are giving the responses. Parallelly, you are seeing, I'm seeing your response in my end. I'm seeing your response in my end. Now the locality of your home. 9 response, out of 10 responses, 7 people are giving rural and 3 people are giving urban. So now I hope you may understand the exact meaning of nominal. Here I am dividing the group of 11 members into 2 categories, rural and urban. This is called characteristics. It's like where you are born, whether you are born, what is that? Your home is located in your rural area or urban basis, I am going to categorize it. The third question I'm going to ask is the open-ended question. You have to type the response here. Yeah, what is your enrollment number? Kindly type your number without space. Don't make it any space. You can type your number. Now, once you type your number, automatically it may comes there. It may comes here. Yeah, number 16, number 9, very good. EME051903, yeah, 1% is given. Yes, so others, only 3 persons are giving the number. Give the number like this, EME, yeah. The next persons, EME01903, EME051904. Here I am asking the number. You are giving us a number, but here having some magnitude value. But here that magnitude value not be consideration for the counting enter. This only for labeling you. For example, in the case of EME051901. I think it's Anita, I don't know who is that. The second number represents one person. The third number, EME051903, represents another person. That 4 represents another person. 7 represents another person. 15 represents another person. So it means that each number labeling or tagging is one person. Therefore, it is called as nominal data. It's called as a nominal data. So I hope all of you understand. No? Those who are understanding these things, go to the Q&A. In type, I can understand. Otherwise, you can type you, I can go to the next level. So I hope all of you understand what is my nominal data. Nominal data means normally whenever you do the research, the demographic variable may lies on the nominal data. So understood. So type down, you can type the name also because I do not know who is typing. So thank you so much for joining me this activity. Now the same kind of activity I'm going with the other example. Just I'm going to close the end meeting. Yeah, understood, Anik. Thank you. So now I'm going to my PPT. Yes, I'm coming to the PPT. Now I'm going to talk about the ordinal data. What is the ordinal data? This terms itself, you can easily perceive what is by ordinal. Ordinal represent order. If you are having any order based, if you are categorizing, then it's called ordinal data. The ordinal scale is the second level of measurement. The level is the nominal, ordinal, it may lies on the qualitative data or characteristics, category data. The ordinal scale it's in the second level of measurement that reports the ordering and ranking of data without establishing the degree of variations between them. Here it's only the ranking order is there. Okay, there is no, we are not taking consideration of the that magnitude value of the ranking. Ordinal represent the order. Ordinal data is known as a qualitative data or categorical data. It can be grouped, name, and also be a rank. The next thing, according to the ordinal scale, the scales involving ranking of objects, persons, traits or abilities without regard to equality of the differences. Here there is a difference is there. For example, if I ask you what is your birth order in your home, you are telling the second. But some students may be a first order. Okay, there is a difference between the order of the position. Okay, so there is a positions only order is there. I don't give the mark for those are burn. What is a burn? As a first child, I'm not giving the 100 mark. If a burn as a second child, I'm not giving the 80 mark. I'm not putting any kind of biasing mark to any kind of people based on the order. It's only the positions to want to know, in the sense I can ask him what is it about the order. Normally, how for even for the height and weight, it may be an interval state. But if you tell the people to stand in the height wise, the particularly in the school's days and all, you may stand in the prayer like what is that? Like ascending order. So one small girl, they may sit, a child may sit. After that, based on the height order, they may stand, because the last person they want to see in the stage, in the sense, those are so high that people only should be standing the last. If they stand in the front, the remaining, those who are very very lower than the height wise, lower than the taller one, they could not be see the things what it happened in the stage. So that's why in the prayer hall and all, always the teachers may tell the students to stand like based on the height order. This was some of the example. How do you feel today? This also order. You are feeling that very happy and unhappy. So if you fix the very happy, means we are perceived that you satisfied today. That is why you are giving like this. That's an order of your satisfaction. Now, how, suppose I am asking that, how do you, whether are you satisfied with presentation? You are giving 5 responses. From the 5 responses, I am able to rate me. I am able to check my feedback from your sites. But that feedback, normally we are using satisfied and all. Satisfied, if you want to check, you can use this kind of measurements. Normally, this is a tool where we can use this for checking the ranking. The school student, first, second, third, etc. Ranking, rating in restaurants. If you go with online tools, even if you go for some online purchasing and all, we may check that 5 ranking, the 5-point ranking. Even the lot of mobile apps come as here, 4.5 ranking or 5 ranking mobile apps. Even some of the hotel, you want to book the food. Now you may perceive that how to book the food in the hotels. That time you may check the hotel rating as a 5-point scale, 4-point scale. If it comes 4-point scale, they're good, and the hotel somewhat is good. If they get 5 points, in the sense, you feel that the hotel is very much good. If you go with one very low level of ranking, you are not going to buy anything. That is showing the position of the hotel quality. Then evaluation of frequency, occurrence, like very often, then totally and degree of agreement, totally agree, mutual disagree, totally disagree. If your one statement is called ordinary, if you are collecting more number of 5 or 7 statements together, then finally the 7 statement consists of 5-5 mark. Each statement consists of 5-5 mark. For example, I am the last question, see here, asking the degree of agreement, there is a 5-point scale. Totally agree 5, agree 4, neutral 3, disagree. I'm giving some numeric value also. Then finally, suppose I have this kind of 5 statement. If I add all the 5 statement, I want to check the entire scores of the 5 statement. It may come as a continuous state. For example, there is a 5 statement, in the sense, each statement having 5-5 mark. Therefore, 5 into 5, 25 mark. The maximum mark for the 25 mark, the lowest mark 5. Because each students are getting the lowest one mark, each question doesn't, they may get 1. Therefore, the scores may deviating from 5 to 25. Therefore, it's like a continuous scale. Then it may lies on the interval or ratio. But if you're taking the consideration only one item for checking, it may lies on the ordinal. Yeah. Now I am going with one demo. I request you all go with once again meeting pulse, but not in, I am going with another URL. That URL is called meet.ps/ordinal. So now I'm going to highlight the example in ordinal data. I request you all to come with ordinal data. Yeah, now I'm going to activate. Once you join, kindly give your name in the chat box. From this, I can easily understand. Now I'm going to start. Yeah. Please, those who are joined, kindly give your name in the questionnaire DA option. 6 students are joined. 6 students are joined. Very good. Ordinal, yeah. The first, Cyril. Very good. What a medical miracle. Cyril joined very fastly. Yes. but he joined as a fifth position here. Anita joined as a sixth participant. This joining as a third. This is called order. I hope you understand the order. The Sarayu, Anita, Dirisha, the name represent a nominal data. The position they joined in this meeting, that is called as a order. There is an order is coming, therefore it's called as a ordinal data. I hope you understand. Musambil joined as a 10th student, 10th participant. Sari joined as a 4th. There you can find out in my screen, you may find out the positions when you join. Anita joined 6th girl, Dirisha joined 3, Cyril joined as a 5th. So thank you so much for forwarding. Nearly 13 people are joined. Now I am going to activate the first poll. What is your favorite eating dish? So you can select the order. Kindly select the order. There is idli, dosa, upma, chapati, puttu. Kindly select the order. You can select the preference order, that order. So you are selecting all the, you can select all the 3 or all the 4 or all the 5, but you have to select and submit. Okay, so only one person submitted. So according to him, the idli is the first preference. Idli is the first preference. Dosa is the second preference. Upma is the third preference. I hope all of you get, yeah. So now this four persons are giving. But in your end, you are getting the 5 options. You are giving the responses, but you are selecting the response based on the order. Suppose if you like dosa, you are fixing the dosa first. If you are like the second as an idli, you are checking the idli. Therefore, it's like a position of your favorite. So the first favorite dish, dosa, according to the survey report, I am following from. The second favorite dish of the entire class member is idli. The third one is chapati. The fourth one is upma. The last one is going to the puttu and curry. Puttu. Yes. So thank you so much for providing. So I hope you understand. Here, I'm not talking about your name. I'm not asking your name, gender and all. Just I am checking what is your favorite dish. It's like a position. Now the third question, second question for you. How do you feel yesterday? So there is a 5-point scale, very happy, unhappy, okay, happy. You can select only one responses. How do you feel yesterday? Here you are fixing the some rating. Very unhappy means it's a 5, okay, it means that you are not happy to sit yesterday. Here most of the people are putting happy, okay in the sense okay, normal, unhappy. So I got 10 responses. Out of 10 responses, I could know that most of the people are happy yesterday. This is called a ordinal. I hope you understand. So I am asking the one question, how do you feel yesterday? There is a 5 ranking order response other, like very happy 5 mark, happy 4 mark, okay 3, unhappy 4, very unhappy is a 5th position. So most of the people are preferring the second positions. So it sees that the position of your or how you can perceive yesterday. That second portion you are telling us, since you feel that you are very comfortable yesterday, you are happy to stay yesterday. That is why I am getting for conclusions. Yeah, thank you. Now I am mounting my presentation. Yes, here I am moving to the third data. It's called as an interval scale. I hope you understand the difference between the nominal and ordinal. Nominal represent is only the characteristics. Here the characteristics or the data may represent or may tag or may labeling one person or one things, but in the interval scale, sorry, but in the ordinal scale, it means it's like a position of the people or position of the data. That is one. Now I'm moving to the interval scale. Interval scale also called as an equal union scales. Scales having equal difference between successive categories. The best example I'm giving is the intelligence scores and personality scores. So normally, most of the psychological variable like interest, normally interest won't be come zero. We can divide the interest in a scale wise like 10 to 20, 21 to 30, 31 to 40. We are able to divide, for example, I'm conducting an interest scale, conducting 100 mark question paper. Based on the people, I'm categorizing the people low, moderate, high. There is an, I'm comparing the three order, low, moderate, high. If I put the name as a low, moderate, high, it's called as a categorical data. But instead of that, I'm taking the consideration only the scores 25 to 35. 35 to 45, 45 to 55. Like that, there is an interval is coming. Normally, it won't be reach the absolute zero. Like interest won't be lies on zero. Intelligence scores also don't slice on zero. Personality, because none other person's personality is not be zero. This kind of variables called interval. Here we can easily magnitude the that particular variables. The interval scale is a third level. It's a third level of measurement scale. It is defined as a quantitative measurement scale in which the difference between the two variables is meaningful. Here, the each variable is very much meaningful. In other words, the variable are measured in an exact manner, not as a relative way in which the presence of zero is allocated. Or it is not, it's like a random only, it's not compulsory to look on the interval. That's why I'm giving the one term, psychological variable, like emotional intelligence, social intelligence, personality, adjustment, then stress. This all the variable never reach the zero. So that kind of variable is called as an interval scale. There's some of the example I'm quoting here. Sometimes you are using a Likert scale, a net promoter score, net promotion, like net promoter scale. Now all the rating system, no, it may come to the emojis based only. See, I'm adding the emoji symbols. Even we are content if you go for some kind of airport, after using the toilet in the out, they may get some feedback devices. That feedback devices, they asking that are you comfortable to use in the toilet. So they given here only the facial reaction, the emoji symbols. So based on your experience, you can click the that emoji symbols. So now the people is moving towards to collect the data like this. Then pi polar matrix table and all. Pi polar, you know that there is a pi in the sense two. It's like a 2x2 table or 2x3 table, that kind of things. The finally, the ratio scale, it's a fourth level, the final level of the measurement scale, which is quantitative. The last one is a quantitative. The ratio scale has a unique features. It is possesses the characteristics of origin or zero point. There's the chance some of the variable, that's why I'm highlighting the word is physical variable, physical data. Some of the physical variable is like height, weight, number of students in the classroom, number of devices in the classroom, number of fans in the room. Like that, if you go with this things, no, counting or physical calculation based, there's a chance that variable may lie on ratio. Scales having the absolute zero, magnitude and equal interest. Best example, height, weight, number of students in a various class. Other examples also I'm going to highlight. What is your weight in kilograms? Some people, they've given us a less than 55 kilograms, 55 to 75 kilograms, 76 to 85, 86 to 95, more than 95. But there's a chance some of the people, because that person's not birthing, otherwise there is a dust having the weight 0.000. It means that the height to weight, there is a chance it may started from zero. But if you go with the emotional intelligence or the intelligence, it not start with the zero value. I hope you understand. If any of the variables start with zero, because the intelligence never start with zero, achievement never start with zero, even the performance. Suppose I'm going to check the performance of dance. If you are attended, damn sure at least I can give one mark. I'm not giving the zero mark because you are present, you know. Even if you're presenting, I'm not able to put the zero mark. So it means that that kind of performance base I'm going to assess you, I could not be able to put zero mark. If you're not coming only, I can put as an option only. I'm not able to put as a zero mark. Because even if you are not writing the examination, how I can write, how I can put the mark as zero? It is not ethics also. So if you're measuring any kind of performance, that is may lies on the interval scale because that performance not reach the zero. But in the case of physical calculation or physical measurement, there's a chance it may lie zero. Yeah, this way I'm giving this example. This example is very user-friendly. See here, the same situation I'm using. There is a, I'm conducting a running race. From the running race, I'm categorizing the four scales. The first scale, nominal. So in the case of Tendulkar, see here, the Tendulkar, the numbers always using the 10 in the back side. Some of the players having the different number. Any people know the Dhoni number, Dhoni t-shirt number? If any people knows, kindly type the numbers. Even some of the football players are always using the same kind of number-based t-shirts. Yeah, Sapphire, yes, 10. I think Tendulkar is 10 only. So here the 10 represent Tendulkar. Dhoni represent Dhoni. Tendulkar 7, I don't know, so I forget this one. Here, the each person can wearing some T-shirt. That T-shirt is representing the one person. Yeah, Dhoni Savani. Yeah, thank you, Mozambique. Thank you. So here, the 7 represent Dhoni. 10 represent Tendulkar. The same way, here the players, each runner, they having some numbers. That number representing the number assigned to the particular runners. The second, ordinal. Once the conductor, we are checking that who is first, who is second, who is third. That position is called, after finishing that, we are checking that the order. That is called ordinal. In the case of interval, the performance rating on zero, I am checking the performance of the people, 0 to 10 scale. I am fixing the mark 8.2, I am fixing the point 9.1, 9.6. This is like a 0.5 performance rating. Otherwise, I am checking your dance. Based on this, I am giving the mark. Those who are getting highest mark, they are the first. So here, I am putting 0 to scales. They put 9.6 mark, 9.1 mark, 8.62. So this scales never becomes 0. Because at least he participated. If he participated in the sense, at least we can give the some comment. At least we may give 1 mark. We are not able to give the 0 mark. Even the scales started 0, but we are not able to provide as a 0 in the performance base. But it's a time to finish in seconds. See here, this is second. 13.4, 14.1. So those who are getting the lowest time only, they are getting the first. But sometimes, if you look into the great man, who is the Usain Bolt, whenever he's running, no? Sometimes he made the record for 100 dash in distance. He finished in the within the minutes in the sense 0.000 before the 1 minute itself he finishes. The second itself he finishes. So he's not able to reach the 1 minute. So it may comes to the, if it comes 1 minute only, it's 1 minute. Otherwise it's less than 1 minute, it's 0.009. That kind of seconds only is coming, no? So there's a chance that it may start with a zero only. There's a start with a zero only. That is called ratio. Now I am moving to the example of the last two scale. I request you all to go with the meet.ps /scale. That is the URL. That is the scale. So once I connected, I can demonstrate how it will be working. This is the example for scale. Actually, in the SPSS and all, there is only 3 classification: the nominal, ordinal, interval. But in the case of SPS, they are going with the interval and ratio. I put in a same like a scale only. That's why I'm adding a CS scale. I'm going with those who are reaching. You can type your name in the question and answer. I'm going to highlight the example of interval and ratio now. Interval and ratio. 9 students are joined. I request those who are joined give your responses in the Q&A. Type your name, then I can perceive who are attended. Yeah, so I'm going to start meeting, then only you may get yes. Now you may get the options Q&A, give a response. Yeah, Arya joining, Anita joining as a 6th attendee, Muzam is joining as a 9th attendee, yes. Then Sari is joined as 2nd attendee, Sofair is joined as 3rd attendee. Yeah, Dirisha. So all the people are joined. Now I'm going to test stream. First of all, I feel more comfortable to participate in this kind of online class. So this is like a, I'm going to check your rating, give a response. Strongly agree, neutral, disagree. Whether are you comfortable to use this kind of online classes? So disagree, very good. Some people are giving the disagree. Yeah. I got 4 responses. Even it's like a ranking one. It's like a ranking. If I'm measuring only 1 question, it may ordinal. But if I continue the same kind of question, I have the 10 questions or 5 questions. Altogether, I'm counting and convert the entire score in a single score. Then it's called as a interval or ratio. Because if you go with the individual item wise, it may take in consideration as a ordinal. But I'm going to take in consideration the entire statements, 5 statements, 6 statements, the final only I'm going to check my the scores of each individual. Yes, now thank you so much for providing the first response. From this I could know that 64% of people are comfortable to use the online class. Then some people are neutral. Second question for you, what is the level of proficiency? So how much you are using? So there's a 10-point scale. Whether are you very much proficiency to use the Google Meet tool? Now you are using Google Meet tool, no? Whether he knows the A to Z of Google Meet, kindly give a response. Suppose if I am giving the task to conduct any online meeting through Google Meet, are you very comfortable to create a code and organize the event? Yeah, so I got 8 responses. From the 8 responses, I could know that most of the people are average level only. Average level. At least some of the people are giving 5, 6, 7 level. It's like a level. See here, it's like a level. It's like a position only. But even though I'm selecting all the questions in the 10-point scale or 5-point scale, if I have the 10 scale, if I have the 10 items, each item has the 10 points in the sense 100 mark. Then after conducting 100 mark, I can summarize the entire report of each individual in a total score. Then it may lies on the intro-law ratio. Yes, so thank you so much for providing wonderful things. Yeah. Yes, now I am come to hear my end. So the final slide for you. Normally, these are things we may go with the features. In the next class, we may be discussing these things. But that's why I'm telling, for doing any statistical applications, the scales of measurement is important. Without knowing the scales of measurement, if you are doing or if you are attempting any statistical techniques, damn sure it may be false only. Be cautious before doing any statistical analysis for your research. So if you know the basic of the nominal, ordinal, intervalled ratio, then only you may get some confidence to do a statistical analysis in features. In this case, just I'm dividing. If you are having the nominal data and the descriptive statistic, you can go with percentage analysis or mode. If you are going for inference statistic, going with chi-squared binomial test. If you are using ordinal data for the descriptive statistic, you can use the median. If you want to go inferential, go with rank order correlation. Suppose if you are using a quantity data like interval ratio, particularly interval, you can use the descriptive statistics like mean, range, and standard deviations. For the inferential, go with the product moment correlation features and factor analysis. In the case of ratio, I already mentioned the quantity data. For doing a descriptive, you can go adopt a geometrical mean. Then if you want to do inference statistics for the ratio data, you can go with coefficient of variations. So from this, I'm going to be conclude presentations. Today we are discussing the three important things, four main things that's called scales of measurement. In this, we are discussing about the nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. The four scales may be divided based on the three characteristics. The characteristics number one, magnitude. The second characteristic or property is called equal intervals. The third property is called absolute zero. In the case of nominal, magnitude, equal intervals, and absolute zero not present. Does not present. In the case of ordinal, satisfying the only one characteristics or one property, only the magnitude value. In the case of interval, it's satisfying the two except the zero and absolute zero. So it means that the interval may satisfy the magnitude property as well as the equal interval property. It won't be satisfied the absolute zero, but in the context of ratio, it may satisfy all the three properties like magnitude, equal intervals, and absolute zero. So I hope you may very much clear about the scales of measurement, nominal, ordinal, and interval. Thank you so much. We will meet next.